You could have a page that literally shares creative compositions of Beanie Babies.
Yeah.
And somebody out there, one of you guys, are going to be trigger happy to say, well, it's easy if you have a collection of Beanie Babies like that. What's going on, guys? Adam Ivey, sellmusic.com, here to help you go further, faster in your music career by sharing proven marketing techniques and strategies to help transform that passion for making music and turn it into a legitimate business that's going to provide you with freedom and fulfillment, two of the most important things in life in general. Now, I'm super excited to formally introduce to you guys one of the members of Team Adam Ivey here. Shout out to Ricky. Why don't you introduce yourself to the audience?
What's up, channel family? So I'm the student success coordinator, and I have the pleasure of talking to probably a lot of you guys who have joined me on discovery calls where we just take some time to really get to know you, make sure that we can genuinely help you out and see what you guys are up to so far. So I've been working with Adam for probably about a year now. Yeah. I've talked to about, probably, what'd you say, maybe 600
students? 600 people.
Yeah. So I've talked to quite a lot of you guys and it's just been a pleasure, super fulfilling job, and I'm just glad to be here.
Yeah, so Ricky wears a lot of hats on Team Adam Ivey. Shout out to Danny as well behind the cameras today, making sure that technology is working smoothly for us. Ricky, like he said, is a student success coordinator here, but that is just the tip of the iceberg as far as what he does. He does a lot of discovery calls for people that are interested in the mentorship program. We work on sorting emails and going through a lot of the admin stuff behind the education. And then Ricky also helps me with some sync licensing stuff and just overall communication that it's really hard for me to keep up with these days. But besides that, Ricky and I met each other years ago at the gym. He was a personal trainer, does a lot of camera work, even for some other YouTubers to this day, hustler through and through. And I knew that he would just be a great part of the team, and I haven't been disappointed yet one time, or maybe a few times.
Yeah, just a handful of times.
Anyway, so what Ricky and I have done is something that I needed to share with you guys. I said, let's set up the cameras, let's do this the right way. Because what we experience on a regular basis is a lot of people that are applying for mentorship. They're sending in emails, sending us DMs, and even some students within the program or the 20 Days of Focus Challenge group. And they're asking, like, Adam, does this stuff still work? Adam, can I grow on Instagram? Adam, how much time do I have to spend? Do I have to do promoted posts? Like, so many different things that are wrapped up into one overarching problem. And that's the self-doubt or the lack of clarity in how to do this stuff. So, you know, we have to be men of our words, you know, a team that not only practices what we preach, but also preaches what we practice in making sure that things still do the work. Because it's a valid question, right? If somebody's teaching you something that worked in 2016 or maybe 2017, and they're telling you to do it the exact same way now, it is something to be a little bit skeptical of at times. So we wanted to go out and do a little experiment, and Ricky and I were talking about, and Danny, we were all talking about an account that Ricky had started a couple months ago on Instagram, just for fun, just like a hobby account that he almost forgot about. And I said, Ricky, no, this is a perfect opportunity. Let's see what you can do completely organically in 1 week's time. It was Monday when we talked about it. He got to work the same day. And I wanted to share his results with you guys to show you what's possible. Quick disclaimer. None of his activity was promoted. None of his activity was paid marketing. Mm-mm. None of his activities on his page were promoted by myself. I wasn't shouting him out to try to, you know, kind of boost the process or anything for that matter. But I'm going to let him share what actually happened. So, Ricky, a little over a week ago, we're going to talk about what happened in 7 days, but a little over a week ago, where did you start? First and foremost, tell them where to find this Instagram account.
Okay, so the Instagram is Captain Ricky, so it's CAPT.RIKKI. I'll go ahead and just pop it on the screen somewhere.
I'll have that in the description box as well.
Exactly.
Go follow it. But when we started, when we were joking about like trying this experiment, I guess, how many followers did you have on that account?
So on the account, there was 52 followers.
Okay. And in 7 days' time, these people just want to know what happened. So let's just give them the big number, and then we'll break down how it happened. So in 7 days' time, how many new followers did you receive?
253
total, right?
Total, yep.
So it started with 50 something.
Exactly.
And now, so almost 200 followers.
Mm-hmm. In a span of
7 days.
1 week. Yeah.
Okay. Now, when it comes to the kind of content that this account is, right? This isn't music, this isn't music marketing, this isn't fitness, although Ricky is into fitness, and I'll have his account underneath in the description box below where you can find his personal account. But What does this account have? And we'll show a screenshot of kind of the grid and what you can expect over there, but what did this account really consist of? Did it have a focus? What was that?
Yeah, so the inspiration behind the account was Pete's Pyre Life. We're all a big fan of Peter McKinnon around here. And essentially, the account focuses on photography, like product photography. So whether it's watches, knives, just like stuff that people carry around either as a hobby that they use it for work or just or something that they appreciate the design of it.
Yeah.
So Captain Ricky, it's like a pirate lifestyle. So the theme of the Instagram page is very moody. There's stuff with like maps and like all this gear around it. So that's kind of what inspired the idea. Something that we talked about earlier was repurposing the Instagram page to begin with, because you're probably wondering how I had those 50 followers from the beginning. So it was a page that I had just forgotten about, and I thought to myself, I'm like, you know what, like, I really like this stuff. I share some of it on my personal account, which you guys are seeing now if you're looking into it. I was like, let me just dedicate a full page to it and then apply the strategies that you already teach on YouTube, which is one of your most watched videos and the video that probably gets referred to in the discovery calls all the time.
What Ricky's talking about, not to interrupt you, man, the what video Ricky's talking about is 1,000 fans in 90 days. A lot of people push back on that. We've seen some pretty creative DMs, like it doesn't work. It absolutely works.
Right.
And quick math, because we talked about this before we started shooting, Ricky received 203-ish new followers in 7 days. If you break that down into per day and then multiply that by 90 days, you'd have over 2,500. It'd be like a little over 2,600 new followers. Now, is there going to be ebbs and flows, or will there be ebbs and flows within the process? 100%. Even at, you know, 50 something thousand followers on Instagram, and I teach this stuff, I still have days where I lose some followers. I have days where I have way more followers coming in than others. And it's all about the averages. One thing I highly recommend is not checking your statistics every single day, because you experience that too sometimes, right?
Oh, absolutely. There were some weeks where I would get, after going and engaging on different hashtags, I would get maybe 4 follows back. You know, the engagement stayed high. People would reply to my comments, but it was maybe just like the content just didn't resonate with them, whatever. I never took it personal, but there were some times where I would jump on a hashtag and I would get 10 to 15 follows right off the bat.
Okay.
So there was definitely, I didn't let it discourage me because I knew it was just part of the process.
Sure.
So it ebbs and flows like it normally would for just about any account.
Yeah, man. So like with the ebbs and flows and you're having these ups and downs and you're getting people driving in, I know that it's not just about getting people to follow you because it's all about building that report. Now, Ricky's a very humble guy, but something I want to jump in before I forget. Ricky, in 1 week, has already had 2 companies reach out to him to do influencer marketing.
Yeah.
Without naming names, because I'm not trying to get their spot blown up. Like, what have they reached out to you? Just overarching, what do they need from you? Or what are they looking for?
So, I started out by mentioning that, you know, here I was new to the community first and foremost, and that I was already so overwhelmed by the amount of attention that, you know, by the amount of love that this community was showing, that I wanted to spread that love to other companies that were literally in the same steps as I were. I mean, a lot of the companies that I reached out to don't have a crazy big following, but they see a guy who's very passionate, who's out there, who's engaging with other people, and they want to work together. I've had offers for having a specific logo stamped on a piece of leather in exchange for some photography. So it was just like showing genuine engagement and interaction to a group of people who have the same passion for what they do that really, it honestly just snowballed from there. It was pretty overwhelming, to be honest with you.
And Ricky had shared with me before we started shooting that there was a knife company that reached out. And obviously, like he just said, they might not be sending him PayPal, you know, payments or anything, but to trade a good that you genuinely like or want, to get that extra exposure, to get that extra experience under your belt, I think it's so incredible to see what you can accomplish in 1 week's time. Now, let's get to the how.
Right.
So Ricky followed some pretty specific steps that are laid out in the 1,000 fans in 90 days video, or are more digestible through the 20 Days of Focus challenge, which you guys, I'm gonna have that in the description box below. It's an open challenge, absolutely free. You just have to click that link or go to 20daysoffocus.com. Pretty easy. You get a free PDF guide that you can print out or have up on your computer. But part of that is the 5x5. You guys can join the challenge to get that exact step-by-step, but what were you doing a little bit, you know, give them some insights of like how much time it was taking, what were you doing on a daily basis, maybe averages type of thing, where you received this amount of attention, this amount of following, this amount of engagement.
Yeah.
Through these daily actions without having a big name, without having a verified checkmark, without paying a agency to do it for you. And again, I didn't promote this on my channel. I was behind the scenes watching it as it unfolded. I wasn't even giving Ricky one-on-one coaching on it every day. And he kind of has an unfair advantage because he's pretty much my apprentice in ways. So tell them what you did. Just like brass tacks, how'd you do it?
So on the engagement side of things, I followed what we talked about, what you talked about in the 90-day video.
Sure.
So I went through hashtags that related to my personal brand. I would go through one hashtag, I would dedicate a certain amount of time in my day, go through it and engage with posts that I actually enjoyed.
Yeah.
That's the one thing that a lot of people miss. I'm not gonna go and drop fire emojis on a post that has nothing to do with what I enjoy, or maybe it just didn't resonate with me. And I think that's the most powerful thing when it comes to this strategy. Mm-hmm. Go through a hashtag with content that you actually enjoy, genuinely interact with something that you liked about that person's content, which I feel like that's another big point of all of this. I could have easily gone into somebody's account that if I saw a watch that I didn't like, I'm not gonna lie and say, hey, dope watch, because then you're gonna see that. It's just not gonna come off as genuine.
Yeah.
So pick a hashtag that fits within your brand. Now, Instagram, something that we were talking about which is something new, Instagram has now limited the amount of posts that you can engage with per hour. And I learned that because I went ahead and commented and was engaging. I had a little too much fun. And then I had my action blocked, which means you can't communicate with people anymore for
like
a certain amount of time.
I
think it was honestly just a couple of hours because it's not like I was spamming anybody's feed or anything like
that. You're just going, you're having a little too much fun.
Exactly, literally just too engaging. So you can do 60 likes and 60 comments in 1 hour. So once I learned that, I took a step back and said, okay, cool. What I'm going to do is dedicate some time in the morning to do 30 likes, 30 comments. Dedicate some time at night to do 30 likes, 30 comments. That's what fit for my schedule, which was most important. Like the biggest thing is make sure that it fits within your schedule because everybody has a different lifestyle. But that's what worked for me, finding a hashtag that I enjoyed within my brand, interacting with content that I actually enjoyed, and then replying to people. Because as you continue to build this engagement and talk to these people, you don't want to forget about the followers that you're gaining because you're searching for more.
True.
You know, so really start engaging with the people that are coming onto your platform, build up their trust, build up that community, and then go out and engage with more people.
Ricky's going to be doing my videos from here on out. I'm just kidding. He's been doing a great job, guys. And the thing that is so powerful about what he just said and shared with you is that you need to enjoy what you're doing. If you go out and you're looking at hashtags and you're looking at posts that are just unengaging to begin with, you can't expect a user to be engaging with you if their posts are unengaging themselves. If you can enjoy what you're doing, if you can enjoy the conversation you're having. I tell this to people all the time. If you're burnt out from a certain hashtag, find something else that you're into. Are you into dirt bikes? Are you into watches? Are you into soccer? Like, there's so many different things. A fan doesn't have to be another music creator. If you are a YouTuber, your fans don't have to be other YouTubers. There's so many people that are out there making music, and there's so many people in the world that have no clue how to do any of that.
Right.
So there's far more listeners than there are creators. Now, in Ricky's case, over 200 new followers. I mean, today especially, it's well over 200 new followers. And definitely check that out in the description box below and go connect with them, say what's up. But the thing is, it's organic. You have to be able to understand communication skills. You're not going to be great at this at first. Not everybody has the gift of gab. Not everybody is a good speaker on camera. A perfect example, go watch my old YouTube videos. I wasn't always comfortable looking into the lens. I wasn't always comfortable with my thought off the top of my head, being able to be spoken in a way that was pretty clear and concise. And I understood my messaging and the vehicle in which I used to deliver that message. Ricky is quickly building an account that he cares for, posting content that he enjoys, talking to people that really resonate with his energy.
Mm-hmm.
And you said I was having too much fun.
Yeah.
A lot of people dread social media. They don't think of it as fun. You have to kind of go in and say, what is going to make this more enjoyable for me? What is going to help me get to the next level? And how much time can I spend focused? Because it's so easy to be wrapped up at swiping posts and, you know, going and being distracted by news and stuff like this. And obviously there's a time and place for everything, but 200 followers in 7 days. Now, one thing in closing, what is one thing that you hear a lot of people, whether it be on discovery calls or the emails, or even people that you're friends with in your personal life, that just have like maybe a misconception about Instagram, for example, that you just want to kind of set the record straight on based on your even your experience in the last 7 days?
Yeah. If it comes to growth, I would probably say that it doesn't work. Mm-hmm. And the reason I say that is because when you are, I think people treat social media as like this barrier, you know, as like there's like this huge divide between you and I, when at the end of the day, you're a human being just as much as I'm a human being. Yeah. And if I want to relate to Adam Ivey, I can just send you a DM or a comment mm-hmm. and say something genuinely nice about you.
Yeah.
It's not about being fake on social media. And I think that's like the biggest misconception when it comes to these things. And granted, my page is not music, so I know there's probably even going to be that comment brought up that like, oh, well, it's not a music account.
There will always be a plethora of excuses.
Right.
You could have a page that literally shares creative compositions of Beanie Babies.
Yeah.
And somebody out there, one of you guys, are going to be trigger happy to say, well, it's easy if you have a collection of Beanie Babies like that. Like, come on, guys. Seriously.
Exactly.
You got to have fun. You got to enjoy what you're doing. But you have to be consistent. And you have to build your communication skills. I'm not going to make this video any longer than it has to be. If you want to keep yourself accountable, definitely join the 20 Days of Focus Challenge. It's free. Literally, I don't need a credit card or anything. Join the massive amount of people who have already gone through the challenge and have seen success, and you're going to do the same. If you don't want to do it, then don't do it. It's fine. But you guys just have to go out there and really understand that this stuff does work. And, you know, if you work the plan will work. That's exactly what we wanted to share with you. So, Ricky, great job. Tell them where to find you. I'll have it in the description box below, but where can
just
they find
you? Just on Instagram, Ricky Hernandez, first and last name. And then for the Captain Ricky, if you're into the knives and the watches and
product
all that stuff, the product
stuff.
Photography stuff, it's Captain CAPT.RIKKI. It'll be.
Takes time, guys. Takes work. Takes dedication. If you have all three, it will work for you. Just be patient. Now, if you want to become a more effective marketer and build that account a little bit more efficiently, click this video next. It's going to help you out significantly. Then join the channel family by hitting that little subscribe button. Smash that bell icon to be notified first anytime I upload a video just like this. Come connect with me over on Instagram @AdamIvey. And until next time, we appreciate you watching.